You may want to set up a spreadsheet in such a way that different cells have different passwords. So keep in mind, by default, once I protect a sheet, if I've set it up correctly, so these cells here are not locked, and these cells here are locked. So what I could do is, let's say I want to send it out, and most people can only input here, most people mustn't touch the formulas, but perhaps for whatever reason, we want certain people to be able to change those cells. What I can do is, next to Protect Sheet and Protect Workbook, is something called Allow Edit Ranges. So when I click on it, this pops up. I'm going to set up a new range. You can give it a name. You'll see it's pointed to what we're looking at. And all it asks is for, what is this password for these cells? So I'm just going to type in password. When I say click OK, it asks for the password again. When I say OK, we'll apply it and say OK. Keep in mind that at the moment nothing is on. We've just told the cells how to react. I need to say Protect Sheet. We'll leave it like that. We can say OK. So now this, I can go here and change any of the inputs. I can't change any of the formulas. Unless I go to this one and I try and change it, it'll then ask, do you have the password for that area? And if I do have it, I'll now be able to go in there and actually make a change. So if you have this setup, that may work. Just keep in mind, I'm just going to unprotect the sheet, is, let's say we've decided that these inputs, most people can play with all these inputs, but maybe the inflation rate only certain people can. Before we can use this feature, we have to change this that it's locked. So on the first version of protection, this Protect Sheet, it must be locked. And let's just change it to another color so it's clear. So we'll make it a slightly different blue. Then we'll say Allow Edit Ranges. You'll see I've already done one previously. So let's just go through the process again. So what we're saying is, that cell over there, password, I'm just going to type in the password. So this could be a different one or the same one from over here. When I say OK, apply. So now what we have is, when I protect the sheet, you can change those inputs, no problem. But if you want to change this one, maybe inflation is now 6%, you need to first know the password. If I can get the password right, then I'm allowed to change it to 6%. So depending on the level of security you need, you can specify a different password for different cells or cell ranges.